Good afternoon and welcome to the 2023 NCAA Division III Field Hockey Championship Game. First round game features the Hawks of Hartwick College and the Frogs of Rowan University. For today, Tracy Macaroli, Jenna Catelli, and a reserve official is Lisa Akija. And now, let's meet the reserves for the Hawks of Hartwick College. Number one, Mackenzie Kenzel. Number two, Mackenzie Hubbard. Number three, Erica Leeson. Number seven, Caitlin Sanzone. Number eight, Zoe Wagner. Number nine, Natalie O'Malley. Number 10, Kate Klotz. Number 15, Brianna Cottrell. Number 17, Taylor Rashi. Number 21, Kylie Marquito. Number 27, Kylie Kramer. Number 28, Amanda Klopper. Number 30, Cheyenne Stowell. And number 32, Emily Holliday. And now the starting lineup for the Hawks of Hartwick College. A defender, number 4, Emily Strutt. Midfielder, number 5, Julie Ruzzi. Midfielder, number 6, Libby Fortin. Defender, number 12, Kiara Dolan. Midfielder number 13, Ashley Tremario. Midfielder number 14, Caroline Esperu. Defender number 19, Sammy Shortino. Forward number 20, Holly Kalori. Forward number 24, Danny Hand. Forward number 31, Hope Angie. And in goal for the Hawks, number 55, Ashley Lupins. Assistant coach is Clarissa Warren, and the head coach is Coach Aaron Otero. Ladies and gentlemen, the Hawks of Hartwick College. And then let's first meet the reserves for the props of Rowan University. Number 00, Aina Ingram. Number 1, Isabel Weiner. Number 5, Kylie Orwell. Number 8, Lindsay Renshaw. Number 12, Katie Meehan. Number 13, Jordan Sponzo. Number 14, Maury Toronto. Number 16, Grace Fenton. Number 20, Abby Petrich. Number 21, Amber Powell. Number 22, Mabel Acuna Casey. Number 24, Abby O'Reilly. Number 32, Madison Murray. Number 33, Serena Marshall. Number 77, Aaron Flynn. And now the starting lineup for the props. A midfielder number 2, Sienna Fusher. Forward number 3, Sydney Pavlishin. Midfielder number 6, Kaylee Wenzel. Back number 9, Olivia Griffin. Forward number 10, Madison DuBois. Back number 15, Paige Yoakum. Back number 23, Tess Carmen. Forward number 25, Vanessa DiDonato. Midfielder number 27, Julia Cavuccio. Back number 28, Aurelia McManus. And in goal for the props, number 88, Mariah Giuliano. Assistant coaches for the props, Darnell Peters, Daniel DeVincent, Danielle Odersitz, Aaron Small, Christina Castagnola, And the head coach is Coach Michelle Andre, the props of Rowan University. And now, those who are willing and able, please rise and remove your hats to honor America and those who support our freedoms at home and abroad with the playing of our national anthem.
Welcome to Rowan Athletics. I'm Justin Lott. Next week, my broadcast partner, Aiden Doherty. We're here for the Rowan Field Hockey NCAA first round playoff matchup here against the Hartwick Hawks here in Gloucester, New Jersey, Richard Wacker Stadium. And Aiden should be in for a good matchup. 11-7, the Profs have not lost a home game since September back against Johns Hopkins. They were ranked number 7 in the country at that point, the Johns Hopkins team was. And Hartwick, they're coming in 12-5. They won their conference as well. Both teams, Profs won the Edge Championship for the third straight year in a row back here Saturday, a 3-0 victory against TC and J. So, Aiden, what do the Profs have to do to move on to the second round and win this one?
Honestly, it is a little bit of an unknown. Obviously, it's not a common opponent you see in Hartwick, but you got to just find a way to settle down. Look, you won the NJAC Championship, but it's time to come back down to a level where the season's not over and the job's not done yet. As same thing with Hartwick. They also are coming off their Empire 8 Conference Championship win. So for both teams, they're going to go through the same thing. They were celebrating just a few days ago, but now it's time to get your game face back on and go play some ball.
Yeah, Hartwick won 2-1 against the number one seeded St. John Fisher. That was on Saturday, where they scored their go-ahead goal in the third period of that one. And that was the closing, again, the Profs 3-0 dominating fashion. It was against TC and J, but overall, the Profs coming out here, got Rich Wacker Stadium wearing the all-brown tops, yellow bottoms, and the Hartwick Hearts all white with the blue numbers. So going through the starters for Rowan, Sydney Pavlishin, Kaylee Wenzel, Olivia Griffin, Madison Dubois, Paige Yocum, Tess Herman, Vanessa DiDonato, Julia Cavicchio, Aurelia McManus, Mariah Giuliano, and Sienna Bosher for the Profs. And for Hartwick, Emily Strutt, Libby Fortin, Kiara Dolan, Ashley Tricarico, Caroline Asperu, Sammy Shortino, Holly Calori, Danny Hands, Hope Angioletti, and rounded off in goal, Ashley Lupins for the Hartwick Hearts as they're just set to get underway. And in this bracket that was just posted this Sunday, Rowan, again, taking on Hartwick, will play either Tufts or Southern Maine. And that'll be on the 11th at 2 o'clock as Tufts and Southern Maine play at 6 o'clock tonight in that matchup. Profs will start with it. Aerial over the top. We'll roll back inside the 15. Slow it down, trying to get it up to the through line. Going to go last touch there by the Hawks. Happened to be Bosher trying to get it through the stick there. Near side by Fortin. Could be possession for the Hawks, it looks like.
No, it looks like the Profs.
It's the Profs, actually.
One off the foot of a Hawk defender.
As now it's turned over. Hawks have possession, just passing the 35 of their own as they turn it over back to Griffin of the Profs. And now an immediate pass over to the other side. Still Hawks possession as they're trying to get it past. Phil got to roll it back. And this is a Hawks team, 12-5. They were second in their conference, the Empire 8. They took down St. John Fisher, who was one of their only losses on the season. They had 5 losses, 12-5, and the Profs 11-7. Had a rough start, but they closed it out. One of their last 7 home games, the Profs did, as Hawks on the push on that outside. Just get the left side diagonal there of Giuliano. He's only allowed 8 goals so far. A couple starts here for the Profs. Push there for the Profs for 40-yard line. Going to be turned over. Now push here, far side. Going to be crossed through. Tended there for Angeletti. Turned over. Slowed down there by Herman of the Profs. Skip pass up ahead. Roll back there for the Profs. City Pavlicek. She tries to just put through a pair of defenders. She does. Pass it to the leading goal scorer, Vanessa Di Donato. Here inside the 30. She tries to run around the defender. She does. Going to be right side. Thinking about a shot. Tries to cross it through. Diving effort there for Lupins. On the second deflection back out. But Lupins diving to her right gets the stop. Now the Hawks with possession.
Yeah, good save because it was either possible shot on goal while also possibly being a cross attempt in. It was a little bit difficult, but Lupins just went out and got it herself and was able to tip it away from danger territory.
Lupins, 28 goals allowed, second lowest in the Empire 8 Conference. 89 saves, 76% save percentage. Had 3 shutouts. That was the second most as well in the Empire 8. Now back. That'll be a kick. They're near side from the Profs, so still be Hartwick possession.
A near opportunity, but obviously a kick. We'll bring it back.
Let's pass up ahead there. Fortin. Fortin to fight it off. Back off to give a go. Skips it past there. Griffin. Now near side. Tap here for Califuri. And slow down. Right side diagonal. Giuliano kicks it out. Now back for Hartwick. Off the left side stick. Going to be a miss.
Tried the backhand, but it did not connect with that middle part, the little loop on the stick, and it just trickled its way out. But a good couple opportunities so far for both sides now, putting some pressure in the shooting circle.
We're through 3 minutes of action here in this first. Ball going to roll off. Last touch there by the Cedar. Would be Fortin of Hartwick. Elliot Griffin tries to pass it up ahead. Right on the through line there, Boscher fighting off shooting her and Fortin. Still cross possession now just at midfield. That one gonna be just strictly out of bounds there off of Griffin's stick. Sets up Hartwick. Again, they had both of their goals scored in the second half of their game on Saturday. So they're pushing up a hand here. Kalori going left to right, tries to split past Griffin. Gonna get whistled. Still possession here for Hartwick. Now back just inside the 20. This will be Ruzzi. Ruzzi trying to split it to the middle. Off the pass in. Deflected off. It's going to be whistled back anyway, but would have been a shot there for Louis Fortin. But
this first 4 minutes and some change, it's been Hartwick kind of with some of the pressure a little bit more. Di Donato had a good opportunity on this right side, but that's been it for the Profs so far. It's been just 2 opportunities to 1, I think you could say.
Hartwick has his team as they have possession. 62 goals scored, only allowed 29. Which averaged just under 4 goals a game as it's cross ball now. Oh, that's that one. Yeah, high stick.
Caught up a little bit.
Deflected off the body there of the Hawk. Now pass there, intended there for Kalori. Kalori trying to fight it off to her Griffin. Now possession back to Ruzzi. Ruzzi tries to split it to her and Boscher. Boscher, Griffin, Griffin. Pass up ahead, turned over. Here's going to be the Hawks. Get Ruzzi. Ergovicio and Gavicio going to get whistled for that one. So, Jude Ruzzi, the senior from High Falls, New York. Got quite a distance for Hartwell Hawks coming in here to Glassboro from Oneota, New York. Going left to right. Trying to split between the legs. They're up Boscher. Gets the move, gonna roll right back off the whistle there. Regardless,
it's gonna be the first corner of the game.
A corner. First of the game, there was 11 on Saturday here. Profs against TC and J, and the Profs had 8 of them.
Yeah, and Now looks like Hartwick is going to get the first one. We'll see. They can capitalize early on an early opportunity. They've been putting on a lot of pressure, but obviously no goals right now to show for it. They could possibly change that right now.
Off the feed. Set up inside the 15. The shot. Off to the second. Deflection. Just gets off the leg. Now back out. Still Hawks possession. Getting tightly guarded. Ruzzi. Ruzzi tries to skip it through. As DiDonato got the stick on it. Now back out. Here for Tricario. And somebody whistled back off the foul. Still in possession. Tricarico tries to get it past DiDonato. Does. Right side. Skip through the cross. It's going to roll out here near the side to cross with possession after get a scary shot there. Against
yeah, I mean, it ricocheted, I think, twice. I think it ricocheted off a player just a little bit, and I think it was a save. And then I think it might have been Cavicchio getting another deflection on to send it to the right of the cage.
Pass up ahead. Little cross. This will be hit up ahead there to Pavlishin. He'll roll out of play.
Skids a little too much, you know, picks up on the turf. It looked like it was picking up speed instead of decelerating.
Now past the 50 here, the Hawks. Get it past Griffin. So it'll be Kenzel there as he turns it over. Tess Herman tries to get it back.
Looks like it went off the foot of Tess Herman.
Herman, one of the three All-Jack first team members for the Rowan Profs. Up ahead, hit off the hand there of Herman. Shakes it off. There's the other two all on Jack first team, Julie Cavicchio, as well as leading goal scorer, Vanessa DiDonato. Pass, sequence of passes. Get it back. Got to be off the foot there of City Pavlishin. So it'll be back here for the Hawks, more specifically. Here at Dolan. She'll send it to the backfield. Turned over. DiDonato. Battling it off. Left side around the 15. Spins. Slows it down. It's a fight on it. And it'll be a foul there calling on DiDonato. So sent back here for the Hawks. This one's turned over. Now slowed down here for the Hawks. And we'll still be possession of the Hawks. Just backing it. Just where they're at. Just around the 38-yard line. That's where 7 minutes and 10 left here in this first quarter. Far side of the field, trying to get it past DiDonato there on the left side. DiDonato gets it off the turnover. She got 17 goals on the season. She gets around Lupins on the second shot. Will go through there for the Profs. So DiDonato gets the cross in off the goal, and it'll be there for the Profs. 6:55 left. Profs take the lead early here. Aiden.
Yeah, good opportunity. You create some pressure. And a lot of the Hawks were on the other end because they were on the attack for a couple minutes or so. And you look to go the other way on the counterattack. There's a lot of space over there and a lot of space on the rebound. And just like that, a 1-0 Profs lead, even though it felt like we were waiting on the Hawks to put one on the board first. But the Profs are the ones to get on the board thanks to DiDonato.
Now far side, the Hawks looking to respond back. Get DiDonato, only All-Jack first team ever. As it was actually assist for DiDonato to Sidney Pavlishin, so. But still a great effort. The first shot was technically by DiDonato, ricocheted back there for the cross into Pavlishin.
I was just looking at the live stats, and I didn't catch who was got the goal, but I think they just officially announced it was Pavlishin, you said, right? No. We'll have to now double check on that one.
Now for the quarter.
Again, the Hawks can counter in just 30 seconds.
Off the back shot. Ruby is going to set up another quarter.
It looked like a high stick, but a smart high stick nonetheless to just try to get out of dangerous territory and reset once again and set your defense up. But the Hawks are off two corners. Have had two pretty hard shots.
Back to Ruzzi, off the pass near side. Tracked down here by Sidwell. But down will set up. Looks to be the third quarter in a row here for Hartwick. 6 minutes, 14 seconds left here in this first. As a pass inside, go right to left. Ruzzi deflected off. Second shot. And that will be a lucky foul there called across. Matter of fact, because that ricochet got in there, but
the Hawks are putting on some pressure. I mean, off the corners, they have some hard shots, and a couple deflections haven't gone their way. But you have to think sooner or later that they'll start going their way.
Back off the cross. Try to get it past Herman. Herman, now makes a pass. Now up ahead. Slowing it down. Back to Palliser. Had the goal earlier. Turned it over. Now the last touch here by Hartwick. Now Palliser puts a stick on it. Tries to get it up ahead there. DiDonato turned it over. Fight there, left side. Now a push. Going to be Keely Wenzel on this left side. Taking the right side there against Lucas. And that'll be called there against the Prof to foul. So just 4 or 5 minutes to go. Hartwick back with possession. Still down 1-0. Now the turnover. Prof's having here inside the 15. Slowly taking it up. All the spin. Going left or right. The Prof's rather defender there was Ruzzi, but turned over off the last touch by the Prof stick, so at 4:40 go, Hartwick looking to respond. Ball placed, just in front of the 20. Back here for Fortin. Out of play by her and the Hawks, so now Olivia Griffin of the Profs. Kicking it back to the line of defense, and McManus. Pass there on that far side through line. Skip pass to herself. It's turned over. Now stopped on a dime. Back there for the Profs. Trying to get past the 35. So stick around the 30, 35. They turn it over. Now going to be just around midfield. Turn it over for the Profs. They'll have it. Herbert kicks it up. Off the pass. Tina now looking to track it down. She has it. Inside the 10. Oh, there's a spin. Pass up ahead to Cavicchio. Cavicchio kicks it back out. Still has it off the second ricochet for Lupins. Now the shot. Kicks it in there.
What a save.
For Lupus. And now back out. Still cross possession. DiDonato trying to split it through. Another cross. Mm-hmm. And it'll be a setup here for the corner for the road cross.
What a save that was. That was a great kick save. It was a great shot. And it looked like it was going to find its way to the back of the cage, but Lupin's just finding a way to get a pat on that one, but still is now setting up a corner here for the Profs to possibly get a second goal.
3:29 remaining. Be the first for them. They're set up. Four around the 15 in the middle. Sets it up there. Shot blocked there off the body there of Troy Carrico. Now to the right side of the pass. This one ricocheted off the stick there of the Hawk. Now fighting the near side again is Troy Carrico. Now Prostel with it. DiDonato gets around one. Trying to split past Troy Carrico. The cross. What a second shot pass, but deflected back out. Hawks fight it off. Shot possession turned over. Left side. Kaylee Wenzel with it for the Prost. She tries to get it off. Pass inside.
Another corner.
And another corner there, the second. This is his last 30 seconds here for the Road Profs.
I mean, Vanessa DiDonato just somehow always finds a way to get past defenders and curl around that baseline and set her teammates up for opportunities, because it's like, I don't know what she's going to do sometimes, because it looks like all lanes are closed and all windows and doors are locked, but she finds a way to get in the shooting circle and sets her teammates up for success, and it led to a corner.
Sets up off the pass. Cavicchio with it. Just around the 15. Pass to the left. Slow down. That one deflected off stick for the Hawks. They're going the other direction. Still well. Her pass. That will be out of play. It's headed there for Carolina Asperu. Possession will still be there. So last touch by the Profs. At the 30 on that far line. sequence of passes. Tignano up ahead. That'll be Pavlishin. They got the one goal off the assist earlier from Tignano earlier. That's inside the 20. Bruff. Still possession here. Slowing it down. Stopping the play. Back to Wenzel. Wenzel going left to right. Tries to get around the defender. Left side of Lupins. And that'll be misplayed there. It'll be back for the Hartwick Hawks.
They just ran out of room a little bit. It's a problem when you go baseline. There's not much room over there. Try to set one of her teammates up in front of the cage, but a lot of Hawks were swarming.
Feed. They're intended there. I'm ahead here, Dolan, but that's just still Hartwick. As that pass there by Louis Ford will be over. Passed and turned over to the Pross with it, just near midfield. Stop there, Ford sticks up ahead. This will be Trent Carrico, tries to get it past Cavicchio. Cavicchio fights it off. Just near the 30 of the Pross. Aaron pass on the bounce. Slow it down, Dinanato. And Wenzel overrun it. So Hartwick with it inside the 30. So pass up there to Aguiletti. Falling off. And Roger McManus. Cross half possession here. Near the 10. With less than a minute to go here in this first quarter. Hawks stop it inside the 35. Slow down the pass inside the 15. Slow down Herman for the Profs. That's it. Now on the push here. Libby Foran. Go left or right. And get the pass through. And attended for the target. And it'll be Carlos. A whistle and foul against Hartwick College Hawks. And we're up to 20 seconds to go here in this first. Still Profs up 1-0. Push far side, pass Peru. Trying to get it past Dinanato. Dinanato puts a stick on it. Now 10 seconds left here in this first. Prof slowly taking it up to round out this quarter. Dinanato gets past 35. But that'll do it for the first. Prof's up 1-0. And what have you seen here in this first quarter?
I mean, early on, you saw a lot of attacks from Hartwick, and you thought maybe they were going to find a way to put one on the board in the first quarter, but they did not. And then you saw the counterattack by the Prowse, and Vanessa DiDonato found her way in the shooting circle, and then her shot slash pass found its way to Cindy Pavlishin, and she pretty much had an open net and put it in the back of the cage. And then they had a lot of great opportunities after that as well, so they got the momentum right now.
Juliana for the Prowse faced two shots, one save, 15 minutes of action. And Lupitz, one goal allowed, two saves on four shots faced. We'll be back just a little, just locking in, Doc, here on Road Athletics. Back here, Rowan Athletics, Justin Lock and Ada Doc. All the call here for Rowan Field Hockey. The first round of the NCAA playoffs between the Rowan Profs and the Hartwick College Hawks. Here in Glassboro, New Jersey, Richard Wacker Stadium. Profs up 1-0 after the first. After the eighth goal of the season by Sidney Pavlicek, the sophomore from New Jersey. And Prost is looking to get retest second round playoffs, which they have done the last couple of seasons. They've been in the Final Four the last two seasons, just fall short in that Final Four game. This on the initial possession was Harwick Hawks, but now back go to be the Prost here near side. Cross. Tended there would have been for Wenzel, gonna roll all the way out the play. So Hartwick will have possession.
Early opportunity. Powell was able to get it in front and pretty cleanly. No defenders got a piece of it, but no one was home on the receiving end of that pass. But again, the Profs all of a sudden have gotten opportunity after opportunity after they scored that first goal. Just kind of riding the wave right now.
As now Hartwick on the attack, far side, trying to get it past. Couple of Prof jerseys, they can't. Now Prof off the turnover, going to far side, inside the 10. Right side diagonal there of Lupins. As we last touch off the stick. So it'll still be a Prof possession. There inside the 10, they'll take it back out low, left or right. Gets it around. Pass puts it back to the right side off the spin.
Another corner.
Another corner. Be the third of the day here for the Road Profs. Okay, they had eight against TCJ back on Saturday. TCJ only had three. And they only hit their three in the last 4 minutes of that game.
Yeah,
TCJ
Yeah, we'll see what they do here. They always set up Cavicchio. We'll see if she can get a shot off or if she passes to one of her teammates. But she has a very hard line drive shot. But recently the passes to her have been a little bit slower and not well received. So there hasn't been enough room to really let it fly, but we'll see if there is room here.
In the middle, Herman, Cavicchio, Wenzel, and DiDonato. Set up, back to Cavicchio, just around the 20, going left or right. Sets up for the windup, slow down the spin, the 180. That shot could be wide right.
Wow. Don't want to be in front of that shot, that's for sure.
Definitely leave a mark.
But it seems like the ball is not getting to Cavicchio as quick as you want it off a corner.
Cavicchio, her pass up ahead there was to be Pavlicek, but foul there called all the Profs. Switch to the first 2 minutes here of the second quarter. Pass near side here for Fortin of Hartwick. Gets a turnover right to Cavicchio. It's for the 40-yard line. Now on the attack, going left or right. Put it down here is Wenzel. Upside diagonal there of Lupus.
Another corner.
And they're set up the fourth quarter here for the Road Profs.
Just great attack, great speed. Found a way to get in the shooting circle and found a way to draw a corner. And again, we'll see. Can they get this ball quick enough over to Cavicchio, who's standing at the top of the shooting circle? And can she get a shot opportunity and possibly put the Profs at a 2-0 advantage?
Good, so we're set up. DiDonato, Cavicchio, Herman, and Wenzel. Wenzel with backed up to the left. Off the feed. Get Cavicchio. Cavicchio passes it off to Herman, right side. And so it'll be
another corner.
Another corner.
Some shoving, I believe.
Probably
the
shoving, yeah. So now the fifth quarter. For the Profs, be the third just in this quarter. Oh, set up. Cavicchio, to the 20, the pass to the left side. The windup, the shot off the kick save. Right back out.
Another quarter. I think it went off the foot, so it'll draw another corner. I mean, how many in a row can we
get?
That's four. We're going back to back to back to back. One of them's got to find the back of the cage, right?
Hopefully they do. 12:29 on the clock in the fourth straight quarter. Pass get to Cavicchio. Or pass to Herman. Back to Cavicchio. Cavicchio swinging a miss. Now go left or right. Wenzel.
And guess what?
This is another quarter. Five in a row here for the Rowan Profs. 11 seconds went off the clock there, so we're 12-18.
We should just commit to the bit. I hope they just keep kicking the ball in the shooting circle or committing fouls and getting us corner after corner. We'll see how high the number can go.
Okay, here of the setup. Fifth straight quarter. Tidalato with this time. Pass to the left side. Wide up Cavicchio. Second reflection there off Lupitz. Still deflected out. Hawks trying to get a pass. Oh. And so cross possession. Out the 15-yard line. Just turned it over. Hawks. There's Tidalato trying to fight it off there for the cross.
Good
and down.
By Herman.
Still cross. Cavicchio inside the 30. Hold off two defenders there. Asperu. Pass back to Herman. And pass across field. Turned over. Diddy Hale with the play. Ball rolled all the way back there to Vélez. Searches pass up ahead. Off the bounce. The Hawks looking to get on the attack. This one. Scare pass inside. Slowed down there. Cross with it. Off the bounce pass. Kick back there to Fortin. Hervey now up ahead there for the cross. Try to get it there to Pavlish. It's going to roll all the way back. Inside the five. Tracked down there by Dolan. Dolan got to try to get it up ahead. Because it'll be last touched off the body of one of the attackers there for the cross. 10:45 to go here in this quarter. Washer comes back into this game for the Profs. Far side Profs possession inside the 30. Stick there, Hawks. Gonna keep it alive for themselves. Now they're on the break. Still down 1-0 after that Pavlishev goal earlier in the game. This one gonna roll just out of play on the through line. Profs possession now left side of the 15. And there for Duboy. There's every last touch there off the stick there of Shana Bosher. It's actually not. So cross possession, Olivia Griffin, just on the 25. Turned over right away, Libby Foran. Our shrink pass, now Hervin, up to Cavicchio, up to DiDonato, pass the 50. Gets around one defender, puts on the speed. One defender, nice in his dust. Now we fight one-on-one on that far side.
It looks like it was a little bit of a drop for the Profs. Just outside the shooting circle, I think, is what the...
Yeah. So just in front of the 20.
They might be originally calling it on the fall, maybe?
Maybe it is.
We'll see.
Now back out. Left or right. Another defender. Could be another whistle. It's a Wetzel. Off to Herman now. Herman the pass inside there. Remember Pavlishin. Fought off just on the goal line. Now this strings us. We'll pass up ahead. The Hawks looking to go on the break. Pass to there for Angioletti. And it'll still be the Hawks just in front of the 40. Angioletti gets it off the feed. Goes left to right. Trying to get it around McManus. Pass intended there, and it will set up a quarter here for the opposite side here at Hartwick.
Yeah, first opportunity here in the second quarter for the Hawks, because they really haven't done anything in these first 6 minutes and 20 seconds, but neither really did the Profs in the first quarter, until they ended up finding a way to get a goal on their rare opportunity, and they ran away with it.
Off the setup, shot, deflected off, batted down. It'll be another corner here for Hartwick.
Another corner. Couldn't really see the signal, but another corner. Again, we're breaking records with this game with the amount of corners we're gonna see, but there still have been no goals to come of it. But maybe the Hawks might have something to say about it.
Pass. And there to Ruzzi. Ruzzi pass to the left. Turned over. DiDonato trying to fight it off. And it's still possessed here for Hartwick. Out to the foul. Left to right, Ruzzi. Ruzzi fight it off. And it'll be a foul. got the ticket, so it'll be Olivia Griffin back for the pass here with the pros. Just a little bit over 8 minutes to go. In the second, just Julia Road Athletics, just Lock and Ada Dock. Call for the NCAA playoffs, first round matchup. Road Profs, the Hartwick Hawks. Denali passes it up here to Pavlishin. Denali to her left. Left up for the shot. Second, bounces back off the save. River outside here to the five. Try to get it to the stick. The last touch there off to the Pavlishin stick, so the Profs turn it over. That one deflected off, still in play, just inside the 40. It'll be last touch there by Cross. To the Cross side of things, it'll be the Hawks of Hartwick. Foran kicks it back to Bruzy. It's her pass, deflects out. Herbert looking to track it down. Gets tripped up. And they'll get called for the foul at Hartwick. Near side pass. Blasher. That fight here for Du Bois. Had one of the three goals against TCJ on Saturday. Now Griffin. Oh, the foul sits it up right at 35. This bounce pass. Kicked up ahead, teed it out, over to track it over. It gets stopped there from Lupins.
Corner. But
that's not a big quarter, yeah. That'll be the seventh here for the Profs. Won't be the sixth in a row, but
it's a good save by Lupins, though, to come out. And, you know, sometimes that can trickle away from you if you save it between your leg pads. But she was able to keep it there and keep it at that. But it still leads to a Profs corner. But they haven't been able to capitalize on any of them yet. We'll see if that can change here.
Set up. Three directly outside the shooting circle. 6:31. Let's go here in the second. Oh, the whistle go. Pass left side, DiDonato. It's a pass here right side. Be Herman. Her shot. Deflected off. The other side. Off the reflection. It'll be Pavlishin. Back out to Herman. Herman misplays it. So the Hawks will have possession. Near side, just around the 30. Last touch by Cavicchio. So it'll be Julia Rizzi. Her pass there, intended for Calori. So Hawks, just around the 40. We'll have it. Ken Rizzi. Her pass stopped there for Bosher. Cross possession after the foul. Bosher goes with Julia Diodato on the pass. As Asperu will hit it off. So foul there against Profs. So still Hawks possession. Except just inside the 35. 5:30 to go here in this quarter. Cavicchio off the turnover for the Profs. So set it up ahead. Ball going to roll all the way back there inside the 10. As Diodato off the turnover. Now it's on the 15. Goes right to left. Off the spin now. Sets up, tries to get the shot. Had easy save there, but it'll set up. Looks to be the 10th quarter of the game here for the Road Profs.
Yeah, it's won't stop. We're already past what? Last game's total in the NJAC Championship for the Profs, where I think you said that they had 11 there. Well, the Profs members have 11 themselves. We'll see if they can spot, but DiDonato just finds ways to set up great opportunities and almost was able to put a goal on the board, but again, once again, sets up another corner opportunity. Again, one of these have to go in the back of the cage, you think, at some point.
Just over 5 minutes. Cavicchio back out. Get a Griffin. Off the pass to Cavicchio. Triples away. Going left or right. Wolf gets tripped up. Fight near side of Mackenzie Kenzel. Cross still in possession. Back out, still fight. Near side for the Profs. Kaylee Wetzel now going left or right. Left side here at Lupins. try the baseline. This handle another tough spot there against the baseline.
Yeah, just run out of room on that side if you try to go baseline. And it looks like she tried to cross it back to her right and just missed her stick with it. Again, these opportunities. And the Prosser are up 1-0, so you could say they're sitting pretty, but the way they've dominated these first 11 minutes of this second quarter, it's almost like it should be more than 1-0.
Pass off the stick of the Hawks. Fought off near side. Hawks get it back off the turnover. Swing and a miss there was by Kate Klotz. Bosch puts a stick on it. Gives it up to Pavlishing. Has a couple Hawks in the area. Gets turned over. Tended for the pass. Now a fight. Kenzel there. Griffin. It's Griffin off the spin. Gets a pass to 45. There. Gets a lift there. It's going to go back here for Hartwick. 3:30 to go here in the second. Still 1-0. Sydney Pavlishing has the one goal for the Profs, her eighth of the season. Scored in that first quarter. Now Bosher, her skip pass up ahead to DiDonato, gets around the one defender, has one to beat, just has Lupins. Left to right with the spin, the shot, finds the cage. DiDonato, her 18th of the season, and the second goal of the day here for the Road Profs.
Wow, I mean, the footwork on that, the speed combined with the ball skills with their stick. He's just finding a way to get in the shooting circle and then not rushing the shot as well. She posted up almost like they're playing basketball with the goalie and spins, shoots, fires, and just like that, the opportunities are starting to get rewarded for the process. Now a two-goal lead with just about 3 minutes left here in this first half.
Profs 2-0 lead, 3:07 to go. Clock ticking out here for Hartwick. Going to at least get on the board before the half. They have it inside the 25, trying to fight it off. Hervin there on the far side. It was Ruzzi. It's a pass up ahead, now back. AJ Letty has her pass intended there. For Dolan's going to roll out of play, so possession here for the Profs. So I'll have it inside their own 15.
We're on a chance.
Good selection here.
What do you think they're spelling?
Spell the good.
Rowan. Getting the fan type here.
Good crowd for get a 2 o'clock game here.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a weird time. I mean, it's a Wednesday at 2 o'clock. You know, but it is a big matchup. You know, we're in the NCAA tournament. We're not the schedule makers here.
Did not. Cross off the turnover. Under 2 minutes to go. Let's even add another goal for their 2-0 lead.
You got to keep being the aggressor. Don't settle and don't sit back just because you have a 2-0 lead.
That one mishandled there, far side by the Profs. It's Griffin. It's Hawks with possession. Get down 2-0.
Hawks got to get something going this last minute 30. They had a couple corners, and that's really been it for this quarter. And it's almost the same thing for the first quarter, even though they started off hot with a lot of opportunities. They're going to have to get some going. Even if you don't score, you got to at least get momentum and try to create an identity and play at your own pace when it comes second halftime.
Hawks on the break. Here, Tricarico on that far side. Tries to cross it all over, but McManus is there to clear it out. It'll go out of play. So possession here, Julie Ruzzi. It's not the 20, tries to get it past DiDonato. Last touch by DiDonato, so now under a minute. The Hawks looking to at least cut the lead in half. Here for the half. They go off the foul there was Cottrell. So it'll be under 30 seconds. Most likely, Prof's just going to hit it around here to keep the Hawks away from it. As Prof's will have it inside their 40. So we're going to roll all the way back inside the 15. headed by Ellis Strutt of Hartwick. Akavichio off the turnover, under 10 seconds to go. Prost was going to get one more shot. Off the second ricochet, he's going to roll back inside the five. And that'll do it for the first half. And the second quarter, Prost ate it up 2-0. Hiddenly here against the Hartwick Hawks, again coming from New York. And again, we'll talk about it after the first, but what have you seen kind of these road Prost? Kind of, what have they done to take advantage here in this game?
I mean, they just keep getting opportunities. I mean, we've talked about the corners. They're now up to – how many corners are they up to now? Because it's 10, I believe you
it
said,
says
right?
10, yeah.
I believe it's 10. But they found ways to be aggressive, and they haven't capitalized on all the opportunities. But if you get multiple opportunities, sooner rather than later, you're going to find the back of the cage. And they've done that twice now, even though the Hartwick Hawks – seemed in the first 5 minutes like they were going to be the aggressor, but they've kind of taken a back seat in this game and haven't really done much since those first 5 minutes.
And for Hartwick, they have 3 shots all by Rizzi. 1 shot on goal by her as well. But for Lupin to the goal, 2 goals allowed, 5 saves on 8 shots faced in the first 30 minutes of action. And then for Rowan, had the first goal by Pavlishin. She has 2 shots on goal. Then Didonato got her 18th goal of the season as she took 2 shots and 2 shots on goal. And Cavicchio also 3 shots on goal, has not gone through. And a goal, Ryan Giuliano, 1 save on 3 shots faced so far in this one to get Justin Locke and Adopi back after a couple minutes here for the second half here on Road Athletics.
Fans, that following this game there will be a short presentation.
I put it to sleep.
Back here, Rowan Athletics, just like Antioch on the call here for the first round matchup, the NCAA playoffs. Rowan Field Hockey taking on the Hartwick Hawks. It's Hartwick with possession. Pross up 2-0. And Aiden, what do the Pross have to do just to keep the lead and extend it possibly here against Hartwick?
Again, don't take a back seat. I mean, I mentioned at the end of the first half, don't take a back seat in the second half. And just because you're up 2-0, you have to play all defense. Find a way. Your best defense can be your offense, and that was what their best defense was in the second quarter, where they were just on the attack the whole time, and their defense really didn't have to do too much because their offense was just so good.
Hartwick out of the half there. Ruzzi on that far side. Back here inside the 15. Two goals scored by the Pross, one by Pallison, one by DiDonato. Up ahead, slowing it down, still Ruzzi. Tries to split between two defenders, does. Griffin fighting it off. Ruzzi still has it. Pass is shot and down, and there's a setup. Another corner here for this game, and it'll be the fourth for Hartwick.
Yeah, if you're Hartwick, you really need this just to get something going. I mean, even if you get a good opportunity, you need to find a way to build momentum, because obviously it's a two-goal cushion for the Profs. So find a way to get one and then just ride the wave for your chance to get it, maybe an equalizer.
Off the corner. Shadow set up. Look to be another one because of Riccio touch there. So set up 13:48, another one. This will be actually the eighth quarter. So we're up to 18, to be exact,
wow,
to the two squads.
It's a generational game right here. We might be breaking records. Most corners in an NCAA game.
Pass off this shot. It's going to deflect off. But it will look to be the third straight quarter here for Hartwick.
Why not? Why wouldn't there be?
We're seeing a continuation, in a row here, these quarters. Especially on this side of the field as well. Cross had, four in a row or five in a row?
Yeah,
here in the second.
I think they had five in a row. Corners are just contagious, I think. And right now the Hawks are coming down with it.
Ruzzi, left shot. Left it back out. Still Hartwick's possession. They shoot it. Going to be wide left. It looks like this will not result here in a quarter. So, we cross possession with the other 13 and a half to go here in this third quarter. Far side, Griffin looking to track it. Up ahead. Was there intended there for Wenzel? The last touch there by Hartwick. Griffin inside the 50. Set up the pass. Sure, there's another through line. Falling off. Hartwick back off the turnover. Pass up ahead, Asperu. As Kalori in front of her. Gets it all the way back to the Pross with Velas. As we last touched by actually the Hawks, so McManus will be set back here. The freshman has been implemented in that starting role later in the second half of the season. McManus sets up. Pass deflected out. Still in. Just saw that through line up ahead. They're rolling back. Now the closest Prof. I'm going to track it down there against Kroik.
Great job by keeping it in.
She does get around the defender. Goes right to left. Tries to split through. Sends up the pass. Cavicchio, the shot. Fires the cage. Julia Cavicchio. Now second in goals with eight now here for the Prof. Actually, she tied Pallison. So they're back again with the tie. Cavicchio, Pallison. Prof's up 3-0.
A little bit of a team battle there. Two goal scorers between Cavicchio and Pavlishin, both getting their eighth goals on the year. But, I mean, it goes back to Vanessa DiDonato just finding a way to keep that ball in play, as it seemed like the Hawks defender was just trying to box her out and let it roll out. But she kept it in, and she made a nice move on the baseline and then kept going and found her teammate, Cavicchio, who was able to put it in the back of the cage, like you said.
So the top three goal scorers for the Pros have all scored in this one. Cavicchio and Palaszczuk are both tied with 7, and now they are both tied at 8. And of course, Di Donato has that 10-goal advantage now at 18. As Al Hartwick down 3-0. Again, loser, though she's led here. As Paige Yoakum goes right to left, out the defender, gets turned over near side. Skip pass up ahead off of Kerwick. And that would be Herman here, the prop, sent it to Griffin on that far side of the 40. Just across the sideline. Has to be turned over. Pass is intended there. Here's time by Du Bois. Du Bois now off the stick. Turns it over. Back to the cross. That will be Serena Marshall. Left side diagonal. Tries to cross it. Still in. Possession still left the Hawks. As I go out of play. So now Griffin at the 25. Set up for the Profs. Pass is intended there for Du Bois. Du Bois fight it off. That'll be off the foot there of Kiera Dolan. A pass now back to Griffin. That's up her pass. So there down back to Marshall, back to Griffin. Rolls away back to the 40. Her pass set up on that far side. Slow down, Marshall fight it off. Gina Hearn, Trent Carrico. Still kick them ahead back to Griffin. Still possession here for the Hawks. Try Carrico. Slow pass up ahead. Back to the 50. Up the face with Danny Hand with it. Third leading goal scorer for Hartwick. Gets it turned over. Now Pross going to go to the other end. With the add to their 3-0 lead, just 2-0 in Rowan Athletics. Justin Locke and Aiden Dock. We have less than 10 minutes left here in this third quarter. DiDonato off the spin. Has Lupins, and it'll be off the kick. Would have been another DiDonato chance there, but off the foul sets up the Hartwick Hawks. Both teams, 26 fouls apiece. 8 shots on goal by Rowan, 1 by Hartwick. Profs have 9 total shots, so 8 of their 9 shots have been off the goal, and 3 have got at the back of the cage. At the 35, Griffin. Turn to McManus. McManus winds up. Her bounce pass. Oh. Set up. So we're going to miss. Now Cavicchio with off the turnover. Gets a pass. Ruzzi. Ruzzi, the leading goal scorer for Hartwick, with 17. There's going to be a pass there from Marshall there, far side. It's going to be Du Bois. Winds up. Fight it off left side. As it'll set up to be the 10th or 11th corner kick. Might have said 10 earlier, but it was 9. So now we're actually at 10.
Yeah. Again, another corner. Because why wouldn't there be? We've seen 3 goals, and none of them have come off corners. It's almost impressive with the amount of corners we've gotten. Usually it's the best chance to score in field hockey.
On the setup. 8:47 to go here in this third. Cross out 3-0. Look to add on. This pass left side. DiDonato, her pass to Cavicchio. Cavicchio winds up. Shot. He's going to kick off a stick. And it'll last touch by the prof. So possession here, Hartwick. That was a bullet there off the stick there of Cavicchio.
Speed on her shot is just it's dangerous. It's not something you want to stand in front of. And it's led to her goal.
There's side DiDonato off the turnover. Fedora goes left or right, gets the speed around. DiDonato gonna wind up. That one saved there by Lupins. This one's near side on the ground. Cavicchio trying to fight it off. And that one off the foot. So we'll set up the 11th corner officially here for the Road Profs.
A lot of corners. still. Just in this third quarter, you know, if you're the Hawks, I mean, you can't act like it's over, because it really isn't. There's a lot of time, and as quick as the props put up three, you could put up three yourselves as well.
Pross on the setup. Empty it out, spread out left. About to feed it, tended there for Wedzel. Wedzel off the backhand, tries to get it to DiLotto. And just a setup, looks to be another quarter. Here will be the 12th for the Road Profs. This time DiLotto is going to send it back here. See McManus spread out left. Then Herman, then in the middle. Set back. It's Herman. Here the other side of McManus. Off the deflection, off the second try would have been a 180 there from DiLotto. Actually, off left, so Hartwick with possession. Just under 7:45 to go here in this third. Ball placed here for Ruzzi. Okay, Ruzzi, 17 goals here on the season here for Hartwick. As Freedom Marshall on the cross, turns it over there, is inside the 20. Pass in, turned it over, Palaszczuk kicks it up ahead of DiDonato, has one to beat. Her shot deflects it off. Slupas goes to the ground, diving to the left on the stop. Marshall tries to get it up ahead off the lefty hit. And it'll be cross possession, just around the 20. Be Kaylee Wenzel. Had an assist there against TCJ in the win on Saturday. Goes left side diagonal. Kick save there. All the splits there. Ashley Lupitz, senior goalkeeper for Hartwick. Try side. Prof still have it. Pass there. Try to get it closer. Off the stick there of the Prof. Emily Strutt was there to defend there for the Hawks. That's where. Under 6.5 to go here in this third quarter. Cross up 3-0. We just do it again. All balls by different players. The first one was Cindy Pavlishin. The second one, Vanessa DiDonato. And the third one, Julia Cavicchio. Far side, Cross trying to get it. Pass through. And it looks like this will set up.
What else?
Another quarter. Kind of wish I knew the record offhand, because.
I'll see
if you can figure it out.
Get my statisticians on it that I definitely have.
Props it up here. For another one, 6 minutes exactly. Cross up 3-0. As Herman flies up. That one off the back there. Of Ashley Tricarico, so set up the Hawks possession. Hawks coached by Aaron Latara was a SUNY Cortland grad at 2014, her sixth season as head coach. Hawks assistant coaches Carissa Warren. Also went to SUNY Wanata. Graduated 2019, the third season. Remember the Profs, been a dominant program the last couple of seasons. Head coach Michelle Andre, eighth season assistant coach, was the player of the year last year, Christina Casagnola, as well as assistant coaches Daniel Altritz, Aaron Swall, and David DeVincenz. Just over 5 minutes to cross. Could get back off the turn from Hartwick. Get both teams just around 30 fouls each. Hartwick's faced a lot more shots. Lupins, 6 saves, 3 goals allowed, 10 shots faced. Compared to 6 shots faced for Giuliano and 1 save. And no goals allowed. Going right to left. It's going to be Asperu trying to get the ball to Herman and DiDonato. There's a spin, that was left to right. And it'll be possession here still for Aspro. She'll roll it over here to Ruzi. Get the leading goal scorer for Hartwick. Go left to right. Had to get through the legs there of Wetzel. So still be Hartwick's possession. Clock ticking down. 4:15 left here in this third quarter. Pass up ahead off the stick. Go down there for Herman. Tries to fight it off between her and Ruzi. And last touch by the Pro, so it'll still be Hartwick just inside the 10. So going right to left again to Asperu. And that one turned over. Herman trying to kick it up ahead. She does it on ricochet off. Stopped at the 40. Going to be possession here for the Hartwick Hawks. Griffin gets it off the turnover. Back for the Profs. This pass up ahead will roll out of play. So it'll be knocked back in here by Kira Dolan for Hartwick. Get Hartwick not on the board yet. 3-0. They won 2-1 against the number one seeded the Empire 8, St. John Fisher's, on Saturday. That gave them their bid into the NCAA tournament. Put in there 12-5. Green Lacrosse 11-7. And it'll set up to be their 10th quarter right here with 3:60 to go in the third.
Again, Hawks have to find a way. Just got to keep finding a way to get opportunities. And this is an opportunity that they need to take advantage of. As you know, we're now just 3 minutes 16 seconds left in the third. You can find a way to get one before the fourth, and you at least set yourself up for a chance to find a way to get this one.
Off the feed, ricochet it off. If you get a Bayless, you got stick on it. We'll roll back out, so still be Hawks possession. Back out here for Ruzi again. 17 goals last season. Going right to left. Try to get around DiDonato. Stopped. Now going left to right. Just has one defender. Trying to beat. Grab the stick. Bat it down. And looks to set up the 11th quarter here offensively for the Hartwick Hawks. 2:45 to go here in this quarter. The third. And this one would be Kyle Quick. On the feed, trying to get it to Ruzi. Deflect it back out. Yoko going to do the nearest Prof, trying to track it down. And it'll be Prof's possession now. Pitching, kiss the head. He's got the Pouchin up ahead to the left. And this pass up ahead inside the 10. I'm going to track it down. Lupus. And here, right side, cross, gets set back out off the clear here from the Hawks. So check out, DiDonato, gets inside the 20. Trying to get her pass up ahead there, would have been Wetzel, who's going to roll out of play. Now just around 2 minutes left here in this third quarter.
Good opportunity, it seemed like Pross are going to get a 2-on-0 of Lupins, but, you know, the pass just still trickled a little bit too far off the stick. And the Hawks were able to recover after that. But again, the Profs still putting on some pressure, which is what you have to do. You can't, again, I've said it multiple times, you can't take a back seat just because you have a three-goal lead. You just have to keep being the aggressor and let your offense play defense.
Is that one? Almost turned over there. DiDonato.
A rocket.
That was a rocket off the high stick there from Kylie Kruick. Pass up ahead, near side, DiDonato. Just side of the 30. Just pass. It'll be tracked down. Isabel Weiler. As both go to the crowd. As Prost still possession. Outside diagonal here of Lupins. Shot. Kick save. Back out. Cavicchio. Left shot. There, another kick save there from Lupins. Back to back. Shots will set up another quarter here for the Rowan Profs with 53.1 seconds to go here in this third quarter.
Again, I'm sounding like a broken record. But one of these corners have to result in a goal for either side, and they have yet to do that. But one of these times, it has to.
Again, 53.1 seconds. 3-0 lead, Profs. Here goes Hartwick. This first round of the NCAA playoffs. Pass Dinanato, wides up. And that finds the back right corner of the keys. Dinanato, her 19th goal of the season. Her second of the day. Profs up 4-0.
Okay, Dinanato is doing it all. Now two goals, one assist, and one assist to me that doesn't show up on the box score, but to me was an assist because it was a shot slash pass, but it was deflected, so it's technically not an assist. But it set up the first goal, and I mean, she has done it all, and then some.
So now Hartwick, 47 seconds left here in this third quarter, down 4-0 now after the second goal of the day there from Dinanato. That was around 10-ish yards out there from Dinanato. Hartwick looking to pass it up here side. It's going to roll out of play. As it would be cross possession. 30 seconds left here in the third quarter. So going to hold another quarter to play here. So Hartwick not out of it completely yet. They still have some time here in that fourth to turn it around, but going to need to do it fast here in that fourth. Clear side, Profs. Yoakum trying to kick it up ahead. Maybe stopped. Asperu. As Hawks for possession, less than 10 seconds here in this third. Deflected there, up stick there of Yoakum. And that'll do it for the third quarter. So the Profs are up 2-0 at the half, put up two goals here in this third. And what could you say? I mean, it hasn't really been off the lot of the quarters, but Profs have just found ways to score pretty easily here against Hartwick.
Yeah, I mean, they've. Look, if you're going to get opportunities, they're at the end going to result in some goals, and the Profs have been a product of that today, where they've gotten a lot of opportunities, and due to that, they've gotten a lot of chances, and in those chances, they've been able to put some of them in the back of the cage, and that's why we're sitting up here with a 4-0 lead for the Profs, and it hasn't been on the other side. The Hawks really haven't had the same amount of opportunities, not really even close at all. That's kind of the story of the game.
Just lock it in, Doc. We'll be back for the fourth quarter here on Rowan Athletics. Back here, Rowan Athletics, just locking in, Doc on the call for the first round matchup, NCAA playoffs between the Rowan field hockey team and the Hartwick Hawks. Profs up 4-0 here at Richard Wacker Stadium in Glassboro, New Jersey. 2 o'clock start time here, and the Profs have been on fire, to say the least. They are up 4-0, coming off a 3-0 matchup here against TCJ just Saturday.
Yeah,
that's Hartwick inside. Looking to take a shot here against Giuliano. Close one. And out of the quarter break here. It's going to be a quarter here for Hartwick again. They're now 4-0. Their season, one of the team's two seasons here on the field, come to an end today.
Yeah, I mean, this could be the last 15 minutes they play. Unless they have something to say about it, and this is a good way to start when you're trying to bounce back.
24 seconds into the quarter. 14:36. It would be the 12th quarter set up here for them. Now 25 combined between the two teams. Set up the shot. They're deflected there of Giuliano. Off the leg. Set up Cali 13th. So now we're up 26 quarters. I'm assuming you didn't get that stat there on the how many quarters is the record.
No, I did not, but I do know that Thomas College and D3 averages 15 a game. So, I'm sure they had just a little bit more.
Back out here for Ruzzi. Ruzzi, left shot. There we go. Off the body there of DiDonato is going to set up. Looks to be another quarter. So now it's 14. So now the Hartwick squad has more as get only 16 seconds have come off in his last three shots. Off the third quarter now, off the give it go. Back out for Ruzzi. Ruzzi's shot, knocked down. And this time we'll set up the cross possession. Far side here, Hartwick with possession. Inside the 10. And we'll drive left side here against Liotto. Back out, kicks rolling out to 25. Gasparu, turned over. Just turned in, Rowan Athletics, cross up 4-0. DiDonato with two goals, Cavicchio and Pavlishin both with one. Cross on the push, gets out of the 15, the pass there to Pavlishin off the spin. Gets a turnover. And we'll be back out. Therefore, Hardware. Driving inside the 15. That one stole there from Griffin. Tracked down. Bosher trying to get it. That'd be Boyce. Chester back here for Hartwick. Around 20. 2 minutes here. Clock stopped. 12:54.
Hawks got to do something on this attack here. They got some numbers now pushing.
They are pushing inside the 10. Go left or right. It would be 13 after Chuck Carrico. E. Junior from Castelovia, New York. You can hear some fans here from Hartwick, but again, it's a good, decent drive from New York. Cross possession. Sends it back to a lot of defense. Done a phenomenal job. Last couple of games, especially. As we're on the push here. Cross on the attack. It's out of 35, we Wenzel. She's going to the backside here. The defense here for Hartwick. She'll turn it over on the pass. It's actually not as back to her, so off the Valerie Asperu. Wenzel going left side against Lupins. Off the cross. Finds the back of the net off his feet in. Looks to be into Pavlishin, so it's going to be now 5-0 cross. And Hartwick, I think the reality is going to set in for them unless they turn off one of the miracle comebacks of all time.
Yeah, they just allowed too many opportunities, and Rowan capitalized on some of them. I mean, this game could be a lot worse. Rowan wasn't able to capitalize on all of them, but they've capitalized on some, and all that's all it's taken to have a dominant 5-0 lead right now. Pavlishin picks up her 9th of the year and her 2nd of the game.
Does they get it? Yes, it was City Pavlishin, so she now takes back the second spot on the cross. A goal scored. As DiDonato, the first leading goal scorer for the cross, kicks it up ahead. Far side, cross. It's got 11 and a half to go. Extend their lead as much as possible they can. Going left side diagonal here against Lupins. Still possession inside the 5. Step back out. Bosher, off the stick there of the Hawk on the defensive side. Corey. Slow down. Ball tracked down. Could be DiDonato. got her second goal just before the minute left here in that third quarter. Time to play. So Hawks now less than 11 minutes to go. Good, now down 5-0. Well, pass inside, right out the 50. Pass near side, taking the other direction, slow it down. 50-50 ball, right around the 50 exactly, or Wenzel. So, possession dropped. Slow it down there, Asperu. Well, that's right, with the spin, slows it down, gets inside the 25. So, let's pass up here to Kalori. And out of the other side, it'll be tracked. And hit up the head, and off the foot. Still playing there for the prof, Sydney Pavlichin. She just got her second goal as well. So two profs with two goals in this one, as well as the other goal from Julie Cavicchio. And the profs here have been electric. I mean, the last three games prior to this one, 6-0 versus Rayopo, as well as a 6-0 win in the EdgeX semifinal against Stockton. And then they went 3-0 against CCJ. And right now, they're currently up 5-0 in this first-round matchup here against Hartwick.
Yeah, I mean, just a dominant. It's like a flip has been switched in the locker room. And it's, you know, you talk about the record not being as impressive as it was, you know, last year and years prior. But they set the standard of, look, when it's time to collect wins, they're going to go get them. And that's what they've done. And that's what they're doing right now.
A team with their fifth straight trip to the NCAA playoffs. They've been a Final Four team twice in the last two seasons prior to this one. Yeah, they hosted the NCAA final last year as well, but fell short against Middlebury, which eventually that team did go on to win the entire thing. So kind of shows you the profs' dynamic, especially coaching staff-wise. And they incorporated really one of their top players last year, Castagnola, to come on the coaching staff as well as the assistant coach. Michelle Andre has done a phenomenal job in the program, and so set up another quarter here for Hartwick. But overall, the profs, more recently with Mariah Giuliano with the goal, have just found a way to keep really anything away from her in all aspects of the game.
Yeah.
Off the feed, Ruzzi sets up left, right side to get it to, try to get it to Torpin, and it'll be set up for another quarter, it looks like. So back-to-back quarters here for Hartwick. 8-4-7 to go here in this fourth. Off the second quarter. This one is wide right. Going to roll all the way back there to the fence. Cross back with it here. 8:30. To go here in this fourth. Cross up 5-0 just to the end. Justin Lockett and Doc on the call. NCAA playoffs, first round matchup. The Rowan Profs at home taking on the Hartwick Hawks. That one will be the last touch there by the Hawks. Roll out of play is Yoakum with the Profs. Will try to send it past. As she'll misplay it off her stick. So it'll be possession here for Hartwick. Caroline Asperu just inside the 35. She also misplays it, so it's going to be Wenzel trying to get it past her. And possession will go the other direction for the Hawks. That looks like it'll be a missed spot now, right around the 36. Goes right to left, around the defender, Wenzel. Puts through another pair of defenders, now back out. Asperger has set up ahead there to Hayes. Now back, fighting it off, McManus. Here's the Pro trying to get away from the two attackers there in this right corner. And it'll be over the goal line there. So it'll be Hawks turnover, Pro's possession. 7.5 left here in this fourth quarter and possibly the game if the Hartwick Hawks don't have a 5-goal comeback in their future. Shreda Marshall gives it up ahead. 35 trying to fight it off between her and Ashley Tricarico. Yeah, now Hartwick off the turnover, looking to push. Reach for him. Turns it over. Profs with it. Sienna Boscher for the Profs. Sends it up ahead. as left to right. Then we go back here for the Hawks, right around midfield. They've got less than 7 minutes to go here to score five, or their season comes to an end. So that was a shot, just a pass up ahead of you, past the initial target, so it'll go back to the Hartwick Hawks. Up ahead, the Hawks stare inside the 10. A little push, go left or right. Wide open across. Got it back out. This will be Herman there on the far side. Trying to kick it up ahead. Extended there for Yogum. It was out of play. Now 6 minutes to go. Pass inside. Slow down right around the 5. Bat it out. Just getting here, trying to fight it off between her and Paige Yoko, but Pross will have possession back. Back the Hawks with it. Oh, they're 30. Set it up ahead. Go left or right. They get it past. Stick there, straight to Marshall. One of Asperu. Trying to get it past. Pair of Pross feathers gets tripped up. And the whistle there called against the Pross the other direction. Wetzel, her pass, right side. Try to get a pass off the spin. Returned over, so Hawks with possession. Now 5 minutes to go here in this fourth. Ball far side. Lefty on the spin. Shortino. And now could be Fortin. Back to right. That pass. Tuffle 50-50 gets run over. And now gonna be left side. Dragged out. Slow down. Goes instead of there for Tricarico. Bounce back out for the 20. Ruzzi again, the leading goal scorer for Hartwick. Cross now in possession. Wenzel can have the one assist tonight. And this afternoon, still bright sunny, even though the daylight savings happened.
Yeah.
Sunday now gets dark kind of early, and gotta make some more people tired. It's 5 o'clock and it's dark outside, but it is obviously not yet. It's still sunny outside here, but so 5-0, 4 minutes left here in this fourth quarter. Have possession. Set up inside their own 15.
The Hawks just really haven't had any opportunities at all. I mean, every time I look up, they get their only opportunities have been the corners. It feels like, you know, they haven't really had a true shot. They haven't had a true shot on goal, I don't think, since the first 5 minutes of the first period. Or first quarter, excuse me.
That would be Hawks possession. Now with our 3.5 to go. Okay, unless they pull off the immaculate miracle of all time, it'll be Pross moving on to the second round. Pross will handle it near side of Wenzel. Now the push is going to be Caroline Asperu. And just turn it over right away, back to Wenzel. Near side, battle back. Falling off the stick there, Shortino. Shortino going to wind up with the pass here, right side. Tracked down by Yoakum. She'll send it on the through line. Battle there, last touch there, Robin. Look to be. There's a little wider. And now for Shortino, the opposite side here for the Hawks. Tries to get the cross up ahead. Look to be tracked down there by McManus. On that far side. Up ahead, it'll go out of play. That far sideline, so it's going to be Hartwick's possession. So, I'd look to get one chance here. We can have. Less than 2.5 to go here in this fourth. Ball goes out of play. That pass tended for Criccio. Gonna roll all the way back here near side. Gonna roll out of play on the near sideline. So it'll be cross possession. Wenzel, her pass was intended there to be for Weiner. Gonna roll out of play. That was under 2 minutes to go. Be open, her pass up ahead. Be kicked off. Batted down. Turned over there to the Hawks. That will turn it over. Herman fighting off near side. Shot 35. Go left to right. Splits the pair of defenders. Her pass up ahead there. Intended for Wider. Wider off the save. Diving attempt there from Lupins. Sends it back out. And that one mishandled there. Was with Yoakum trying to save it, but going to be out of play. Still is Yoakum. So last touch there by the Hawks. Her pass turned over. Asperu with the get back. And now going left to right. Fight it off. He'll go to Asperu, try to get it away from each other. Now under a minute. As Ruzzi is up there to Shortino. Back cross, turnover. So that far side, tracked down there by Cottrell. Try to fight it off. Yoku now gets it. 40 seconds left. Right side, off the spin. Set up a, looks to be a quarter here for the Profs. This is again 31.8 seconds. This is completely out of reach, but the Profs looking to maybe possibly get the sixth goal of the game.
31 seconds left. You don't want a front run, you know. But you know, you get someone an opportunity. Find a way. Yeah, there's some players that aren't always out there. Get some NCAA tournament action and pick up a goal, possibly.
Set up. Clock running down. Set back. Slow back out. McManus. Left to right. Off the spin. It'll be a turnover. So that'll be around 20 seconds. The Hawks possibly get one long distance shot in here. We're going to look for. Around 35 yard line, now 10 seconds. As it turned over, the Profs under 5 seconds, looking to track it down. And that'll do it. The Rowan Profs win the first round matchup of the NCAA playoffs for the fifth consecutive year. And they did it pretty handily, 5-0. Yep. And they've now won their last four wins, combined score of 22-0. Wow. Which is unbelievable. Again, Brian Giuliano has adapted well to that goal. Yeah. Red shirt freshman for the Profs. Didn't get to start again all year to start it off. It's Aida Ingram. But Giuliano has kind of adapted well. And the line of defense hasn't really given, especially you said it's Hartwick. See, once a couple goals went in, once it was a 3-0 lead, then it was 4-0, it was pretty hard to come back from.
Yeah, I mean, this program has now set a new standard of 5 straight years of NCAA tournament wins alongside back-to-back-to-back NJAC championships. I mean, it's just a very winning program, and they continue to set the standard every year, and they made the Final Four a couple times in those 5 years, and hey, look, man, maybe they can do it again. So we'll have to see what's next.
Yeah, the Profs, they had, again, 5 goals, 2 from Pavlishev, 2 from DiDonato, 1 from Cavicchio, and they are set for a matchup either against Tufts or Southern Maine. Southern Maine and Tufts play tonight at 6 o'clock, and the winner will face on against the Profs, and that'll be on the 11th, to be Saturday at 2 o'clock. So I was good, I was just a lock. Next to me, Aiden Dock. This was the Rhodes win, 5-0 against the Hartwick Hawks. Hopefully you enjoyed the game, and hopefully you enjoyed the rest of your day and night.
Number 2, Mackenzie Hubbard. Scott. Number 5, Julie Ruzzi. Number 6, Libby Fortin. Number 7, Caitlin Sanzone. Number 8, Zoe Whitener. Number 9, Natalie O'Malley. Number 10, Kate Klotz. Number 12, Kiara Dolan. Number 13, Ashley Tercarico. Number 14, Caroline Esperu. Number 15, Brianna Cottrell. Number 17, Kate Olachi. Number 19, Sammy Sortino. Number 20, Holly Calori. Number 21, Kylie Marquino. Number 24, Danny Hinn. Number 25, Jess Betts. Number 27, Kylie Quinwick. Number 28, Amanda Clapper. Number 30, Cheyenne Stillwell. Number 31, Hope Angioletti. Number 32, Emily Holliday. Number 55, Ashley Lupin. Assistant coach and associate head coach, Carissa Warren. And head coach, Aaron Otero. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulate the Hartwick Hawks on an amazing season. Ladies and gentlemen, our final score today was Rowan 5 and Hartwick. No score. Congratulations, Rowan. With today's victory, the Rowan Cross advanced to the second round on Saturday in Babson Park, Massachusetts. For tickets and more information, visit NCAA.com. Best of luck to the Rowan Cross in the next round. On behalf of the NCAA, we thank you for your support of NCAA field hockey. For all spectators, thank you for attending today and your support of the NCAA championships. Good afternoon, and please travel home safely.